students, now we are going to derive expression for magnetic field on the axis of circular current loop. So this is a circular current loop. At this point, this is the axial point. At this point P, this is a point P. At this point B, what is the total magnetic field? So very simple. As usual, we are going to take that according to Biot-Charvet law, dB, which is equal to mu naught 4 pi IdL sin theta by S squared, because this is a small elemental length dL. Here also elemental length dL. The current is flowing in this direction. So the current I flowing in this direction. Then the dL and the point B meeting distance is R. Here we are taking as a S. Okay, so in Biot-Charvet law, we are assuming as this is a R, but in our question, we are taking it as a S. This S value is A square plus R square. This A is the radius of the circle and R is the distance between the center of the coil and the point P at which the magnetic field is going to determine. So B is equal to mu naught 4 pi IdL sin theta by S squared. So first you have to understand the diagram, very simple. So this is a small elemental length. Joining the line is a R in Biot-Charvet law. Here it is a S. So it will make an angle pi. But here the DL and the S will make an angle 90 degree. It is exactly. So if it is a curved path, so at the, from the curved path only the S line will be drawn. So the DL and S vector is theta is equal to 90 degree. Here the sine 90 is equal to 1. So if you substitute theta is equal to 90 degree, we get an equation dB, which is equal to mu naught 4 pi IdL by X squared. That's all over. The problem is solved, because for the small elemental length at the point P, the magnetic field is dB, which is equal to mu naught 4 pi IdL by S squared. But this magnetic field is resolved into two components. That is a sine theta component and cos theta component. So dB can be resolved into two components. dB sine theta along the axis and dB cos theta along perpendicular direction. Because don't see that, sir, cos theta always comes to the horizontal and sine theta always comes to the perpendicular in previous cases. That means the cost component is a horizontal component and the sine component is a vertical component. We have to see from here. So this is a, what is that? Vertical component. This is a horizontal component. So very simply we can take in that axis will be a sine pi and perpendicular to the axis is cos pi. So this cos pi, this elemental length cos pi will be in the downward direction. This elemental length cos pi will be upward direction. Both the cos pi will be equal and opposite, cancel each other. But both the sine pi will be in the same direction. We have to add up. This dB sine pi is a total magnetic field at this point P for the entire circular loop. So very simple, students. Biot-Charvet law, substituting the theta value is equal to 90 degree, we get a dB. So dB is resolving into axial, that is a dB sine pi and dB cos pi. dB cos pi will be cancelled. So it means clearly the perpendicular components are equal and opposite and cancel out each other. That is dB cos pi will be cancel out each other. But their axial components are add ups. That axial component is dB sin pi. The total magnetic field at point P is integration of dB sin pi. So dB is mu naught 4 pi IdL S squared into what is the sin pi value. So sin pi is, this is a pi, this is the opposite side, this is a that is a hypotenuse. So pi is equal to A by S, opposite side by hypotenuse side, opposite side by hypotenuse side. So we are going to substitute that sin pi, which is equal to A by S. So B, which is equal to mu naught by 4 pi, I A is taken outside, S cube is taken outside, integral dL. So integral dL means dL is a small elemental length. So integral dL means total circular loop. So the circumference of the circular loop is a 2 pi r. Here the radius is a. We can substitute 2 pi a. So what will happen? So a, here we get a square. So mu naught I a square by 4 pi s cube. So here the pi get cancelled. This 2 will come. So 2 into what is a s value? R square plus a square whole power 1 by 2. Here it is a s cube means r square plus a square whole power 3 by 2. This is the expression for circular loop magnetic field. The point P at a point P, the circular loop magnetic field is B is equal to mu naught I A square by 2 into R square plus A square whole power 3 by 2. Here also similar to the infinite long wire, we have some special cases. If it is a n number of terms, just you put N, that is a capital N here. For the first case is at the center of the loop, that means center of the loop means here we are taking the R, you know, if the R is taken as a 0, if the point P comes to the center of the loop, what the equation will become? So mu naught ni a square 2 into R will become 0, so a square whole power 3 by 2, 2 to get cancelled, a cube, so we get a cube. Here this a cube and this one will be get cancelled. Finally, we get an answer mu naught ni 2a, which is equal to b. So this is very, very important derivation for a circular loop. The magnetic field value at the center is mu naught ni by 2a, where a is the radius of the circular loop. We can represent this equation in terms of the area of the circular loop as area. That is, area is equal to pi a square. Here you substitute pi a square, denominator pi a square. So we will get the pi a square into a is a pi a cube. Here the pi a square is equal to area a. So we can rewrite this equation as in terms of area of the circular loop. Similarly, at the axial point far away, so that is r is very, very larger than a, the area, the radius of the loop is very, very smaller, the r will become a bigger value. R is very, very greater than the radius of the circular loop. What we will take? If the r is very, very bigger value, a will be neglected. So what is this equation? Mu naught ni a square 2, then r squared. This a will be neglected, so r 2 to get cancelled, square and 2 will be get cancelled, r cube. We get r cube. So pi a square is a area. So just you multiply pi on both sides, numerator and denominator, we get this equation. Then if r is equal to a, r is equal to a means the point r, point p lies at the same distance of the radius of the loop. R is equal to a means we get an equation mu naught ni by 2 power 5 by 2 a. So very simple students, the derivation for magnetic field on the axis of the circular current loop is very simple. By applying a Baeyer-Sawart law, we are converting, we are substituting the values, we get an dB. dB is resolved into two components, only the axis component will be add up, then you substitute the sin pi value a by s, we get an expression B is equal to mu naught I A square 2 into R square plus A square whole power 3 by 2. We are having a three different special cases and we completed. Okay, so this is the pages for copying in your classwork note. So diagram is very, very important students. So very important derivations we are seeing in this week. So what is Baeyer-Sawart law expression? The expression for the current carrying conductor, infinite long wire current carrying conductor, and the circular loop also. So these derivations are very important for exam point of view.